After studying this module, you shall be able to know the concept of product mix, understand the various factors that affect the product mix and their scope, know different product mix strategies, learn the concept of product line, and identify the different factors affecting product line. Let us now understand the meaning of the term product mix. Marketing mix concept was first proposed in the year 1960 by marketer E. Jerome McCarthy and has been widely used by marketers since then. Marketing mix is nothing but a set of tools used by the marketer to rope in as many customers as possible so as to gain maximum profits. This marketing mix comprises of four components, namely product, price, place and promotion. These four components are popularly known as the four P's of marketing mix. A marketer has to use a combination of four P's to develop a profit yielding strategy. The problem is there is no standard proportion. The company has to work with different permutations and combinations of four P's. After understanding the basic concept of marketing mix, let us now know what product mix means. Product mix, also known as product assortment, contains planning and merging the right type of product that will satisfy fully the wants and needs of the customer. It contains many product lines that an organization offers. An organization may have just one product line in its product mix, and it may also have multiple product lines. During marketing of products, a marketer wishes to make a successful mix of right product, which is retailed at the right price, is in the right place, and is using the most suitable promotion strategy. To make the exact marketing mix, marketers have to see the following conditions, such as: number one, the product has to have the correct features. For example, it must look good and it must work well. Two, the price should be actually able to fill the gap of the need of the consumer. Three, the goods must be in exact place at the right time. Four, and lastly, the target group needs to be made aware of the existence and availability of the product through promotion process. We would now learn about the types of product mix. Product mix is a set of products offered for sale by the company. Any company will have the following product mixes, namely width, length, depth, and consistency. We would understand these four concepts briefly one by one. We would take up the first concept, width, first. The width of a company's product mix pertains to the number of product lines that a company sells. For example, if a company has two product lines, its product mix width is two. Small and new businesses will usually not have a wide product mix. Number two, length. Product length relates to the number of total products or items in a company's product mix. For example, a company may have two product lines and five brands within each product line. Therefore, product mix length would now be 10. Third concept is depth of a product. Depth of a product mix pertains to the total number of variations of each product. Variations can include size, flavor, and any other distinguishing characteristics. For example, if a company sells 3 sizes and 2 flavors of toothpaste, that particular brand of toothpaste has a depth of 6. We would now understand the concept of consistency in a product mix. Product mix consistency relates to how closely related product lines are to one another in terms of use, production, and distribution. A company's product mix may be consistent in distribution but vastly differ in use. For example, a small company may sell health bars and health magazines in a retail store or several gyms. However, one product is edible and the other is readable. The production consistency of these products would vary as well. Let us now understand the different factors which influence changes in product mix. Number 1. Change in market demand. The change in the demand of a product which may occur on account of changes in habits, fashion, purchasing power, income, attitudes and preferences of consumers affect the decision of product mix. 2. Cost of production. It is a very important factor that influences the production mix. For example, if the company can develop a new product with the help of same labor force, plant and machinery and techniques, it can decide to start the production of that product at lower cost. 3. Quantity of production. Keeping in view the production capacity and other factors, the quantity of production is decided in order to achieve the economies of scale. 4. Advertising and distribution factors. Advertising and distribution factors may be one of the reasons for the changes in production mix. If the advertising and distribution factors in an organization are the same, the company may take the decision to add one more item to its product line. 5. Use of residuals. If a residual can be used in a gainful manner, the company can develop it into main product or sell as an alternative product, which may have a good market. For example, a sugar mill can profitably develop production of paper cardboard or wine from biogases. Another example can be of Mother Dairy, which sells both butter and the byproduct of butter, which is buttermilk. 6. Change in the desire of the company. Keeping in mind the objectives of the company may eliminate some of its unprofitable processes or may start a new, more profitable product. In this way, the company tries to make its product mix an ideal one. 7. Actions and reactions due to competitors or competition. The decision of adding or eliminating the product may be as a reaction of competitors' actions. If the company thinks that it can meet the challenges well which have been posed by the competitor by making necessary changes in the size, color, packaging or price, it can decide to make such changes. 8. Change in purchasing power of the consumer. If the demand of consumers increase with the increase in the purchasing power, the company may think of adding one or more product lines, keeping mass production or increase in profitability in mind. 9. Change in behavior of the customers. If the company feels that there is a change in buying habits, fashion, taste, or temperament of the consumer, necessary adjustments so that the consumers capture new market as a result of changed behavior. 10. Overall profitability. Overall profitability must be considered as this is the most significant factor that influences product mix. Any change in terms of product mix should be viewed whether it affects the profitability in any way. 11. Full utilization of marketing capacity. If the company is not getting desired results from the market, it can decide to stop the production of such a product and divert its resources to produce a new product or improve the existing product according to the needs of the consumers. 12. Financial resources. Finance is the lifeblood of the business. Availability of the finance may necessarily bring about some changes in the product of the company. If the company is short of finance, or if the product is continuously going into loss, the company may decide to drop such production. Similarly, if the company has sufficient funds, it may improve its products. Let us now understand the different product mix strategies. The best product mix for a company is one that directs resources towards products with the highest potential to increase profits and revenue for the company. Development of a successful product mix strategy depends on analyzing existing products for market growth and market share. Some production mix strategies under BCG metrics are stars, cash cows, problem children, and dogs. They are being discussed as under along with other production mix strategies. Number 1. Stars. Star products are those products which have high growth combined with high market share. Therefore, in this situation, the appropriate strategy would be to place marketing resources and attention onto these products to push them towards market domination. 2. Cash cows. Cash cows are those products which are saleable products with high market share but low growth. A cash cow position is the ultimate goal of all products. In this successful position, profit is maintained with little marketing or resource allocation. 3. Problem children or problem child. These products are those which have high growth products with low market share and are known as deemed problem children. These products have potential to become stars or cash cows, but it can be difficult to reach that position. 4. Dog. Dogs are those products which have low growth and low market share. These products should be removed from product mix once it is no longer profitable to produce these products. No marketing, advertising, or undue resource allocation should be used for these products. Maintain the products as long as there are loyalty buyers. 5. Need satisfaction strategy. Before designing a product, it is necessary to ensure whether it is going to add value, fulfill a desire, or make life easier for the buyer. Therefore, even if the price is higher as compared to the rival or competitor's product, if the product satisfies a need, a want, the consumer will buy it at any cost. 6. Under an overpricing strategy. Underpricing products may increase volumes of sale. However, it may not result in profits. So, before slashing prices, one must think twice about the profit margin. Moreover, marketers think if the product is unique, they can overprice. However, there will always be the risk of cheap duplicates in no time. 7. Premium prices strategy. Premium products can have premium prices. For example, designer clothes or customized goods can have higher rates. Such products are targeted to the upper class. Although, where there is not much option available with the customer, premium price can be charged. 8. Good after sale service strategy. Most electronic goods companies are following this strategy because the consumer is always worried about the product requiring service or repair. However, if the service is not good and involves delays, customers will shift loyalty. LG could do well only because of the good after sales service it had. Moving on, we would now know what a product line means. A product mix contains of various product lines, which are groups of related items that customers tend to use together or think of as part of a group of similar products. Product lines may fairly be similar or totally different. For example, dish laundry, detergent liquid, and powders are two alike product lines. Both are used for cleaning and created on same technology, whereas deodorants and laundry are completely different product lines. The levels to look at the product line can be: number 1, category product line level. At this level, accountabilities are related with dealing two or more brand product lines within the same product group. In this condition, the marketer may manage products that offer similar basic benefits but goal their assistances to somewhat dissimilar wants. Multiple brand product lines allow the marketer to cover the wants of more segments and subsequently increase their chance to produce sales. 2. Product mix level. At this level, accountabilities contain two or more group product lines that are dedicated to dissimilar product groups. In some cases, the category product line may return similar general solutions but are meant at completely dissimilar target markets. In large corporations, the product lines are very varied and deal with different solutions. The following points need to be considered about a product line. 1. A product line is too short. If profits can be enlarged by adding items, the line is too long if profits can be enlarged by dropping items. 2. Company objectives affect product line length. One objective is to make a product line to encourage selling. Thus, BMW would like to move consumers up from BMW 3 Series to 5 to 7 Series. 3. Product lines incline to lengthen over time. Excess manufacturing capacity puts pressure on the product line manager to improve new items. The sales force and suppliers also pressure the company for a more complete product line to content customers. But as items are added, some cost rise, such as the design and engineering costs, inventory carrying costs, manufacturing changeover costs, order processing costs, transportation costs, and new item promotional costs. 4. A company lengthens its product line in two ways, by line stretching and line filling. Major product line decisions involve product line length, which means the number of items in the product line. If by adding items to the existing line, the profits can be increased, then the current line is too short and vice versa. Adding and removing items to and from a product line is a strategic decision of the company, as it involves company's objectives and resources. A company can also introduce new products in the existing line in the beginning or at the end of the line. This may be due to a response to the market competition or to introduce new products in the market. Number 1. Product line decision. Depending upon the resources, competition, market position and other factors, the product line has to be extended or shortened by adding new items or dropping existing items from the list. 2. Line stretching decisions. An organization can stretch its product line downward, upward, or both ways, beyond its current range. Downward stretching would mean adding low-end items in the product line. For example, in Indian car market, watching the success of Maruti Suzuki in small car segment, Toyota and Honda also entered the segment. B. Upward stretching means high adding high-end items in the product line. For example, Maruti Suzuki initially entered small car segment but later on entered high-end segment. 3. Two-way stretching means stretching in the line in both directions if an organization is in the middle range of the market. 3. Line filling decision. Line filling can be done by adding more items within the present range of the product line to reach for incremental profits or to utilize excess capacity. In offering a product line, companies normally develop a basic platform and modules that can be added to meet different customer requirements. Car manufacturers build their cars around basic platform. Home builders show a model home to which additional features can be added. This modular approach enables the company to offer variety while lowering product costs. Let us now recapitulate what we have learned so far in this module. Product mix, also known as product assortment, contains planning and merging the right type of product that will satisfy fully the needs and wants of customers. It contains of many product lines that an organization offers. An organization may have just one product line in its product mix, and it may also have multiple product lines. A product mix has several dimensions about the product, broadly like width, length, depth, and consistency. And lastly, line filling is done by adding more items within the existing line filling is done by adding more. Repeat. Line filling is done by adding more items within the existing line filling by adding more items within the existing line.